100.9, 106.5, K-Rock.
Good morning, everybody. This is the show. You are listening to K-Rock. Now, we have a very special guest in the studio with us right now. We will call this person Oscar Wilde. Are you over there, Oscar Wilde? Hold on. Let me see if I got this on. Oscar Wilde, go ahead and talk for me.
Good morning.
Yes. All right. Oscar Wilde is here because if you have lived in Central New York, you don't even got to live here to know about Oscar. But we had a store in, I guess, the North Syracuse area called Switz's growing up. It is now CX Tech. It's a big store. Had a big Halloween display. And in that Halloween display, if you grew up here, you knew that Oscar was going to be there. Giant 14-foot tall animatronic ogre-looking thing.
Yep.
Switz's closes. Nobody ever sees Oscar again. And then this lore has started to build up around, no offense to our guest, but it's a giant, you know, Chuck E. Cheese animatronic, essentially. It's not like it's anything crazy.
I was just asking around just to see if what people knew or heard or whatever, just real quick. And it's exactly what you just said. There's just a lore about it of, oh, I don't know, I heard this or that, or it ended up on a boat going over to, you know, up where in Canada somewhere. I'm like,
I have never thought much about Oscar. I have, obviously, the nostalgia that we all have.
See, I have.
You have?
I think I'm more on the side of, where is it? What's going on?
So the story that our guest has to share, it's been a crazy journey. But you, sir, own Oscar now, correct?
That is correct.
You have Oscar.
That's awesome.
Oscar is hidden, correct?
That is correct.
Oscar is hidden for, I guess, your and your family's safety, no? Like, you get people trying to find Oscar, right?
Yes, not to be dramatic, but, you know, it's a very life-harrowing event to have Oscar.
And if you're going to find out here in a second, the journey, how our guest got Oscar, didn't even know he was buying Oscar. He was buying something else, and Oscar was included. So,
I didn't know that. Okay,
guest,
cool.
Guest, could you tell me kind of the journey, you know? So Switz's closes, this giant Oscar ogre goes missing, and to now you have it. What's the journey that you know about Oscar? Where did it go?
Well, there is proof and documentation that it was in some guy's garage in Cicero, New York. That's on Syracuse.com. You can actually see that article. And there's a picture of the former owner with the head next to it. From there, that's where the trail gets kind of fuzzy. There's all sorts of reports that he ended up at a haunted attraction in Camillus, New York, to where he was left outside and scrapped. There's also reports that, you know, he ended up at a haunted attraction up in Messina, New York, and that's kind of where my trail picks up.
All right, so it ends up in Messina, New York.
That's what I heard the last that he went, I don't know the where, but that he was sold off to, like, New Jersey or something, long gone.
Right. So, and for those of you curious to why we're disguising our guest's voice and hiding them off camera, it's because, guest, you've had people come to your property, right? You've had people try to find Oscar?
We've had threats. We've had people on our property breaking into our storage facility. We've had people show up at our front door. We've had all sorts of trespassers. We get all sorts of Facebook messages, text messages. It's been quite insane how he's such a local phenomena. I mean, you travel outside of Central New York, nobody really knows, but how intense people have for this, love for this, like you said, a Chuck E. Cheese animatronic.
Yeah, that's all. It's really all it is, but it does have a local importance to us. So it's in Messina, and then how do you acquire Oscar, the giant animatronic from Switz's?
So there was, it was apparently involved with this haunted attraction up in Messina, New York, to which had an incident to where a lot of items were destroyed. Oscar was then packed into the back of a transport vehicle, and that transport vehicle was then bought by a private collector in another state, Connecticut. Being a person myself who has certain transport vehicles, this post goes up on the marketplace. Somebody sends it to me and say, hey, you should bring this vehicle home. So I look at it, and I talk to the guy. I'm like, oh, yeah, I love this vehicle. Yeah, it's a good price. And so I go all the way out there, and it's literally the whole back end of it's just packed with Halloween decorations and all sorts of cardboard boxes and junk. And we load the vehicle on the back of the trailer and, you know, spend the time coming home with it. Bring it home, start unpacking all the boxes, and I'm pulling out this metal framework. I'm pulling out motors and wires, and I could kind of see how it gets together. So I assemble it, and next thing you know, about 65 to 75% later, I'm like, oh, this is Oscar.
Wow. So you were just buying a transport vehicle that somebody had used at a haunted attraction somewhere. You start to go through all the rubbish like in the back of it, and you notice that I think this is Oscar from Switz's. So you you didn't set out to buy Oscar from Switz's. You just acquired him?
Yeah, I didn't set out to buy him. I just went out to get something else, and he was shoved into the back of a transport vehicle with a bunch of other props.
Now, from what you've said, so people are like, well, how do you know that this guy genuinely has it? I guess I don't. I have not put my eyes on it yet. I have seen photos of it, and I've known this person, our guest, for many years, and we have mutual friends who have verified that Oscar is there. So I personally have never seen anything more than photos. But you have a lot of people a handful of people who have seen Oscar.
There's a local attraction north of Syracuse. I won't say the name as they asked to remain anonymous too, mm-hmm. because once it was found out that I was associated with them, they were getting harassed as well. So, there's a local attraction that has several very adept people who are at prop restoration, and they have physically come to our facility. Seen him, and we've come up with a plan for restoration.
We are talking our guest here, the current owner of Oscar, the giant Switz's animatronic everybody in Central New York is obsessed with.
Yeah.
So you say restoration. This thing is in bad shape, right?
To be honest with you, he should be thrown out.
Yeah, wow. Explain its current condition.
So as with anything, you go into grandma's attic and you find something that's made out of foam or latex and you touch it. It disintegrates into your hands.
Mm-hmm.
And then you've got old circuit board components made from the 80s, and a lot of those components aren't even available anymore. And they're corroded, they're rusty. You've got 80s speakers made with the old paper cones, if you will. They're really not even paper, it's like mm-hmm. a cardboard foam cone.
Yeah.
And they just disintegrated. The wires are, they dry rotted. A lot of the frame is rusty. The main frame is there, but like some of the motors and actuators and things as such are seized up because, they were compression or liquid or motorized and the grease dried out or whatever, or the cock screws on them seized up. And it's a very deplorable condition.
So Oscar is in a bunch of bins right now, basically, right? And he has to undergo a restoration, which can you share how much that's going to cost?
The last estimate we had pre-COVID was $14,000.
Whoa! $14,000 to restore Oscar.
Would it be easier just to build a new, here.
Yeah, are you essentially just building a new one, or is it going to still be Oscar?
Well, we're going to probably use a lot of the original framework. A lot of his original pieces can be used for reference points to rebuild or reconstruct.
Yeah, perfect. Yeah.
Because, like his jaw, for example, it's 3 foot wide almost, and it's all foam. There's no saving that foam.
And you've mentioned before that you don't need anyone's assistance. You're not looking to do a GoFundMe. You want to handle this on your own. Why is that?
The last time we attempted a GoFundMe, a scammer tried to do a similar one and then tried to claim ownership of Oscar. So we decided that it would be just better to be kept in-house.
So the point is, you're going to handle Oscar.
Yep.
Oscar is safe. Oscar is tucked away. Oscar's so safe that I offered to go see Oscar last week, and I can't right now because it is tucked away. He has offered before to show me Oscar, and I will go see Oscar next year to prove to everybody that Oscar is still around. I just haven't yet. But once Oscar gets restored, will it be visible to the public? Will we be able to go see Oscar somewhere?
Yes, I've been working for and with a local attraction north of Syracuse who has promised to build a facility to house him indoors because he's not an outdoor prop, apparently.
Mm-hmm.
And once he is done, they will make accommodations to have him there.
All right, and it's not a small facility, right? Like, how big does this thing need to be?
Well, you need something that at least 12 feet wide, 16 foot high, and can accommodate a 1,600-pound animatronic.
Oh, my God.
Can you think of any other questions that would help with the validity? Everything sounds like this. Our guest has Oscar.
Yeah, there's no reason whatsoever to believe that this would be a lie in what any way whatsoever.
I've known this person for years. I've known associates for years. I don't feel like I'm being lied to. I don't know why people would doubt this.
Nope.
All he is asking is he doesn't need money, doesn't need your help, doesn't need assistance, doesn't need any of that stuff because it gets wonky and people are crazy about this thing.
Yeah. Sounds like you need some people to not be psychos.
Not be psychos about it. And you can do this all on your own, or do you have a team that's going to help you reassemble
stuff? Oh, I have a team.
Yeah, okay.
I will profess that I do not know everything about animatronics and props and things as such. I'm just the idiot that ended up with them.
All right, anything else that you want to say to assure people that Oscar is well, that you've got Oscar? Anything else that you want to say, guest?
Well, I guess... I hate to say this, but the significant other has stated, the wife with the old man in his car, that one day he came home, the car was gone because it was too much of a problem. Mm-hmm. If it continues to be a problem where people are continuously to harass us or show up, I probably will come home one day and he'll be gone.
Yes. Yep. So knock it off.
Be cool.
Everybody be cool. Yep. Oscar is being rebuilt, restored, and you'll be able to see Oscar. How long do you think? Years, 2 years, 3 years?
I'm going to say 5 years tops. We were hoping to start it this summer. An incident occurred to which inhibited me from beginning that process.
Mm-hmm.
But we're hoping probably next year, once things settle down a little bit and I can get back to somewhat normal.
And I will do my best in the spring to get out to this facility and show some kind of evidence that Oscar is well. We don't need to have all these internet arguments about where he is, what he's up to.
Close up of a tooth.
Yeah, something. I don't know. All right, listen. Guest, thank you so much for coming down. I hope this has answered some people's questions. I know
awesome.
It's a big deal here in Central New York. We appreciate you making the time, sir.
All right, thank you.
All right, thank you. That is our guest, the current owner
Wow.
of Oscar the Animatronic.
That's crazy.
So keep tuned in. We'll be giving you updates as we get closer and closer and closer, all right?
Yeah.
Come back after Beatty Boys, K-Rock.